Shalom family, God bless you. This is your prophetic intercessor Amel, and I'm pleased to have you back on this channel. Thank you for always coming back. Thank you for the love, the support, the prayers, and the words of encouragement. I always receive them with a heart of gratitude. And if this is the first time you're seeing me, or the first time you've decided to click on my videos, thank you so much for doing that. I know you're never going to regret it in the name of Jesus. I do believe that God led you here because he has a word for you through me, and I pray you stick around long enough to get that word. Please, if you're yet to subscribe to this channel, kindly consider subscribing and becoming a part of this family, so whenever there is a new content, you're not going to miss out on it, in the mighty name of Jesus. So today the Lord was teaching me about the reason why some people do not get their miracles, why they do not get their blessings, why they pray over and over again and they still do not have solutions. Is because they have kept God in a box. They have kept God in a box. They know in their minds how God should operate, how God should work, and without that they don't expect God to work. Sometimes God is asking us a question and our answers clearly shows that we are not even ready to get God to work. We are not even ready to see him in our lives. The man at the pool of Bethesda is a great example. He had been at the pool of Bethesda expecting, praying for a miracle for many years, and yet he could not get his miracle. And Jesus comes in front of him, the great healer comes and asks him, "What do you want to be made whole? Will thou be made whole?" And the simple question he would have answered is, "Yes, I want to be made whole." But he started by presenting his problems to Jesus. "I do not have any man." Of course, in the pool of Bethesda, an angel came every year to stir the water. And whenever the water is stirred, the first person who jumps in gets their miracle. But this man has been lying there years after years, and he's not been able to be the first to jump into the water. And Jesus is asking him, "Do you want to be made whole?" And he says, "I have no man." That was not the question. That is the problem with many of us. We are believing God for financial breakthrough, and God is asking us, "Do you want to become wealthy?" And you say, "Lord, I have no job." That was not the question. So many times God wants to bless us, maybe through using another means, and we have already square-pegged God, like he's going to bless us through a job. He's going to bless us through someone. The question is, do you want to be wealthy? Sometimes God wants to give you a multi-million dollar idea and you're there every day praying and believing him for a job. That is not what God wants for you. You have reduced God to helping your finances only by giving you a job. And God is asking you, do you want to be wealthy? The answer should be yes, Lord. I love Habakkuk. In the book of Habakkuk chapter 2 and verse 1, "I will stand my watch and set myself on the rampant and watch to see what he will say to me and what I will answer when I am corrected." He says he will stand on his watchtower to see when God asks him a question, what he's going to answer, because your answer determines how fast you get your miracle. It determines how fast you get your breakthrough. So many of us who are believing God, maybe for a kingdom spouse, you're in a relationship and you're believing God to marry, and God is asking you, "Do you want to get married?" And you start complaining to him, "Oh, the partner, the person with whom I'm in a relationship is like this, is like that, is like this." You have already reduced God to only answer your prayer for a kingdom spouse by giving you that man. Whereas he has many, you forget to know that he's the perfect matchmaker. He can just recreate a love scenario for you with someone else that's going to be better than you had ever known. But you have reduced it. To you, what is a miracle to you is that God makes you to marry the person you're in a relationship with. And God has far more better for you, but you've reduced him to that place. He's asking you, "Do you want to get married?" And your answer to him is, "Lord, this person I'm in a relationship with is giving me headache. If only you convict their hearts." That is not what God wants for you. God wants you to say, "Yes, Lord, I want to get married," and watch him do the miracle, and watch him matchmake whatever he wants to matchmake, or watch him turn that person you're in a relationship with who is giving you headache to become a perfect spouse. The man at the pool of Bethesda said, "I have no man," and that was the wrong answer. He was standing right before the great physician. Right before the great physician who could make him heal at an instant. And Jesus, by his mercy, said to him, "Come on, rise up, pick up your bed and go." But that was not the right answer. But that was not the right answer he gave. God is talking to someone right now. He is saying to you, "Do you want to be wealthy?" that you have reduced God to something that we don't know. You've reduced him just to maybe giving you a job, or you've reduced him just to sending you someone that is going to give you money, forgetting to know that 1,000 cattle on a hillside belong to God. He says the silver are his and the gold are his. He can make you have wealth in whatever way he chooses. It's just for you to say, yes, Lord, I am ready. Be it done unto me according to thy will. I am ready. Whenever he calls, say, Lord, I answer. Whenever he calls, answer. Do not answer a question with a question. Jesus, in front of Mary, after the death and burial of Lazarus, Jesus tells Mary, your brother will rise again. And Mary, you know, that is our problem. We try to calculate God. We try to figure out what he is saying and what he means, rather than just going with him, to him with a virgin mind, expecting to hear what he would say and expecting for him to do it and deliver just the way he deems it fit. And Mary says, yes, I know he's going to rise again on the last day, forgetting to know that she is standing in front of the resurrection and the life. And Jesus says, take me there. Take me to the tomb. And he raises Lazarus from the dead. If you are getting this message, if this message is coming across to you right now, it's because God wants you to change your mindset. Do not put God in a hole. Do not put God in a box. God can do exceedingly, abundantly, above all we can ever think or ask of him. He is well able to do that. Do not try to limit God. Most of the times we are not limited. I always say most of the time we are not limited by the God we serve, but by the God we know, because we have limited. The God we know has been limited to operate only in a particular dimension. The God we know has been limited in his capacities to help us. We have kept God in a place that has limited him from working in our lives. As this video gets to you, I pray that your mindset has been changed and transformed to let God work the way he wants to work. So when God asks you, what do you want, or do you want this to happen to you, we are going to have the right reply, the right approach to God, so that we do not limit his work in our lives. Most of the times we are limited by our reaction towards God, and not by God himself. Sometimes by his mercy, he bypasses our reaction and still does what he wants to do. But other times, our reaction actually shuts the door for our miracle, for our breakthrough. I pray for you that as you listen to this word, it's gonna change your mind, and it's gonna open up your mind to the possibilities that there are in God. It's gonna reshape our mindset to know that God can do anything at any time and anywhere, in the name of Jesus. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May he cause his face to shine upon you. May he be gracious to you, and may he give you peace. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen. God bless you.